Good morning, my name's Paul Esker. I'm the Extension Field Crops Plant Pathologist here with UW-Madison and UW Extension, and we're at our Janesville, Wisconsin winter wheat variety trial site. We're coming up on the Feeks 8 growth stage right now, and we'll talk a bit about more of that in a second, which is a critical time to be out scouting the fields for many of our foliar diseases that we might consider using foliar fungicides for. And a couple of the key points I think we'll discuss in this short video today include: how should we go about sampling a field to make these assessments? What are we identifying, and which leaves should we be identifying? So our first point when we're scouting at this time of the year, mid to late May here in Wisconsin, what we need to keep in mind is that we want to get an estimate of the level of disease. Two measures we think about are incidence and severity across that field, in part because we could just get out from our truck or our vehicle, scout a small patch, say there's a lot of disease here, make a decision to spray, and realize that the level of disease throughout that whole field is very minimal. So ideally, we want to take many different approaches to getting that sample and trying to get across the field as a whole. We've written in the Wisconsin Crop Manager over the last year or two a couple of articles that explain the scouting methods, and we would recommend you consult those again to go out there. But ideally the goal is to go out, sample about 10 points across that field. Within those 10 points in the field, take 10 stem samples from which you're going to assess the level, what disease you find, and how much is there. And we'll talk about what leaves to focus on at this critical juncture. With that in mind, what diseases are we talking about? So over the course of the growing season and spring into summer for wheat, there's a lot of things we might deal with. Coming into the Feeks 8 growth stage in Wisconsin, there's a few that in particular we are most interested in. Year in and year out, it seems to be powdery mildew, although in 2009 in our assessments around the state, the levels of powdery mildew we are seeing in the field is rather low. Another one that we're most interested in and that we see year in and year out typically is the Septoria leaf blotch complex. We do have some evidence of that, and in a second we'll look at a leaf sample of what the early symptoms might look like. The other ones we deal with at this time of year, and we are starting to see, although the levels, the severity of the disease, which is how much of the leaf area is infected, is pretty low, are the leaf rust and the stripe rust. We've had a cool spring. We've had stripe rust in Wisconsin the past couple years. We have seen some initial evidence of it. Thresholds for making a recommendation to spray are slightly different from the Septoria or the powdery mildews. We're not going to talk today about things like Fusarium head scab. That's something we'll do later in the season when we get around flowering. Nor will we talk about Steganospora, which causes gloom blotch. Again, that's something we would expect to see on the flowering head. So to tie really the concepts together, we've taken our samples from the field potentially. We're wanting to assess them. We have some threshold concepts we can use, or threshold levels we can use, for Septoria, powdery mildew, and wheat leaf rust. Stripe rust, we don't really have much for thresholds at the moment, nor do we have much for some of the other diseases. That's part of the research we're conducting at places like here at Janesville and across the state to get a better idea of how the varieties respond that way. When we're at Feeks 8 or the flagleaf emergence, what we want to keep in mind is we're most interested in assessing from that flagleaf, and here's an early example of the flagleaf emerging out. And probably the flag, what we term flag minus one, or the penultimate leaf, flag minus two, or the second leaf below, even on down for some of the diseases down to flag minus three. And in a recent, in a March Wisconsin Crop Management newsletter article, what we talked about were these different threshold concepts. So when we're focused at this time, say for Septoria leaf blotch or powdery mildew, we're really focusing on the flag leaf, flag minus one, and flag minus two for our assessment. When we discuss the wheat rust diseases like leaf rust, we do bring in the flag minus three leaf. So really, what are we looking for? The three diseases we've just talked about have slightly different things we're going to be focused on for a threshold. For Septoria leaf blotch, And to show here, we have an example of some of the symptoms on the lower leaves, which again for thresholds don't help us a whole lot. Here, these are early lesions of Septoria leaf blotch. One of the distinguishing signs of this disease are what are termed pycnidia or black fruiting bodies with that, and they're usually pretty easy to find. In our threshold concept, we're working on, again, the upper part of that canopy, flag minus one, flag minus two, and our threshold is a value of incidence. So how many of the plants have this? And our threshold would be 25%, which means if we took 100 samples, 25% of those, or 25, would have evidence of Septoria leaf blotch on the flag, flag minus one, or flag minus two. For powdery mildew, we use a slightly different threshold. We use severity measures. Same three leaves, flag, flag minus one, and flag minus two, but we use threshold concepts or ideas that are about 5 to 10% severity, which is not a lot of pustules when you think about it. But historically, what we've seen over the last couple of years is a lot of infestation of powdery mildew in the lower canopy, not necessarily always in the upper canopy. For wheat leaf rust, the threshold is a bit lower. It's about 1 to 3% severity. Again, if you recall, we're talking about the upper foremost leaves, and why that is the these leaves contribute more or less the majority of the photosynthesis that will be needed for the final yield in wheat. For other diseases we might see, and we do see anything from early evidence out in the field right now, some virus-like symptoms, to maybe some bacterial lesions out there. These aren't controlled by foliar fungicides, and at this time, we wouldn't recommend making a foliar fungicide application to manage those diseases. So kind of in closing, as a reminder, at the flag leaf emergence, which is where we are coming for a lot of the state right now, we're either at the first, second, or flag leaf sort of growth stages, first or second node, I should say, and flag leaf, you're wanting to assess that upper canopy to make the threshold decisions. Foliar fungicides can be effective. However, their effectiveness will be a function both of the environment. Today's a very windy day, for example. It's drying the canopy really well. We might not expect a lot of leaf wetness. It will also be a function of the variety. Part of our reasoning for doing work at the variety trial location is to understand how these varieties differ in their reactions. And it's also going to be a function of the level of disease and where we're finding it. So in years where we've had heavy powdery mildew, we do see a yield increase of about 7 to 10 bushels per acre with a fungicide application in that FEEX 8 to FEEX 9 growth stage, so the flag leaf emergence. However, again, know what you've planted out there, be active in scouting the field, and be active in taking good assessments to identify the disease and how much, whether it's an incidence measure like we do for Septoria, or a severity measure for something like powdery mildew or wheat leaf rust.